Thank you. I wanted to get away from the mind reading thing and the sort of select the card thing and show you sort of an interesting thing to do with gambling. And it's one of a story thing. It's a story I made up years ago based on a true story. Would you shuffle the cards for me? You should. These kind of things must be done from a shuffle deck. I usually work with borrowed decks. So obviously when a borrowed deck is handed to me, it's sloppy, it's dirty, corners are bent, and it's been shuffled. Okay. Now the story is, well, you've all heard of stacking a deck, I'm sure. The word is actually stack. But since everybody says stack, I'm going to say stack also just to make it easier, okay? Now, what I'm doing right here is looking for the aces, no big deal. But the whole point here is to see if you people can catch me stacking the deck, okay? I need one more ace. If I can find that, we're off and running. Here it is. Okay. The story goes like this. It seems that there were four men playing with a card shop. And that brings up an interesting question. You should be asking yourself, well, if he knew he was a card shop, why were they playing with him? They wouldn't play with him. Well, it's a good question. It's a logical question. It has a very logical answer. It seems that the card shop was a little careless this evening, and whenever he turned the deck face up, which he was doing inadvertently, the men would see the four aces on the bottom. He'd give them what is known in the trade as a belly cut like that, and then he'd take a few more cards from here, and he'd cut the deck a few more times, but it didn't matter. No matter what he did, when he flashed, they saw the four aces on the bottom of the deck. So finally, the four men turned to this card shop. They said, look, buddy, not that we don't trust you, because we don't. Would you mind if we put the aces into the deck ourselves one at a time? That way we know you're not cheating. Well, the card shops couldn't very well say no, because that would be admitting his guilt. So we very meekly said yes. And then what happened is one of the men who knew a little bit about cards cut a few cards. He made a fan out of those cards. This is called a fan. He took one of the aces, put it into the fan, pushed it in to make sure it was lost. He closed the fan, made sure that ace was lost by taking a few more cards from here and putting them on top of these. He in turn handed the deck to the next guy, who took another ace, put it on the face of the deck, gave the deck a cut like that, took some more cards from here, put it on top of these, and completed the cut. The card shop was getting nervous, started to look through the deck, but it was too late. He couldn't find the aces because the third guy took the third ace, put it on the deck, gave the deck a cut like this, took some more cards from here, put it on the deck, and completed the cut. Well, as I say, the card shark was getting nervous trying to find the aces. He just couldn't. There was no time because the last guy took the last ace, put it on the deck, gave the deck a cut, took some more cards from here, and he completed the cut. Well, the card shark looked at the four men and he said, look, fellas, you guys have lost the aces in such a way that you yourselves don't know where the heck they are. He said, I demand the privilege of giving the deck two straight cuts. That's all I ask. Well, they had a little committee meeting. They said, what the heck, you can't do any cheating with two cuts. Well, let him do it. So he took the deck and he gave the deck one, two cuts, just like that. And then he said, you know, guys, it's getting very late in the evening. Boy, it sure is late. He said, let's play a very quick but cutthroat game. We'll play cutting to the highest card. Whoever gets the highest card wins. That's fast. That's quick. He said, but I am so sure and so confident that I can beat you four fellas that not only will I have to cut to a higher card to beat you, I'll have to cut to a higher card of the same suit. In other words, if you cut the nine of spades, I won't beat you with the ten of hearts. It has to be the ten of spades. Is that fair enough? They said, sure, that's fair enough. So the card shark picked up the deck in one hand, gave it a cut, and turned over a king. One of the men did that. One of the men turned over a king. The card shark said, look, I'm going to try to beat you. He was about to cut the deck when the four men said, you know, buddy, we still don't trust you so much. We know that one of us cut to a king. We'd rather you cut with one hand. That way we know you're not cheating. He said, well, if you insist. He took the deck in one hand, gave it a cut, and turned over the ace to beat that particular king. Well, at this point, the second guy said, wait a minute. Let me use a little logic here, a little common sense. He says, this guy's stacking the aces. I know he's stacking the aces. Where is the most logical place for the aces to be? I got them. They got to be on top. So I'll cut the top card, get an ace, and I'll beat this son of a gun. Well, he did that, but believe it or not, he too cut to a king. So the card shark said, look, guys, you insist upon cutting to kings. You insist that I cut with one hand, so I will. And he did. And of course, he got the ace to beat that particular king. Well, at this point, the third gambler said, hold it. Hold it. This is no coinky-dinky. This is no coincidence. He said, this guy is stacking the aces. I know that. All it takes is a little common sense. I just saw they're not on top. I don't think he's that good. They can't be in the middle. He said, no, I got them. There's only one place they could be, and that is on the bottom. They got to be on the bottom. He turned the deck over, cut the bottom card, and he, too, cut to a king. So The card shark said, look, guys, you insist upon cutting to kings. You insist that I cut with one hand. He said, now you're getting fancy. You're cutting the deck face up. He said, I don't have to do this. But to prove that I'm not cheating, I'm going to cut the deck face up like that and cut to the ace to beat that particular king. Well, at this point, the four guys got up and they started to walk away. And he said, hey, doesn't pay to play with this guy. We know he's cheating. We can't catch him. They all got up to walk away. The card shark said, hold it, fellas. I'll tell you what. He turned to the last guy, the one that hadn't cut yet. And he said, I'll make a deal with you. He said, before I tell you the deal, give the deck a legitimate honest shuffle. Would you do that? The guy said, yeah, I'll do that. Now the card shark said, why don't you give him a legitimate cut? Never mind these top and bottom cards. Give the deck a legitimate cut. The guy said, fair enough. Cut the cards. And would you believe it? He cut to the last king in that deck. The card shark said, here's my deal, guys. If I can't cut to a card in this deck that will indicate the position of the last ace, I'll pay you all triple what you've lost. Is that fair enough? They said, sure. They all sat down again. The card shark took the deck on one hand. He gave him a cut and he turned over a four. Well, they all grabbed for the money. The card shark said, hey, hold it, fellas. Hold it. You misconstrued me. I didn't say that I would cut to the ace. I said I would cut to a card that would indicate the position of the ace. Now, that's a four. Look, one, two, three, four. And, of course, he got the ace to beat the last king, which should teach you never to gamble with strangers.